Hey, well, today's daily sprint. We're talking about increasing our purpose, passion, and meaning and growing our business today. And thank you for letting me into your hearts, heads, and homes. Now, I'm going to preface this, that this is something that I'm really passionate about because I worked through it. Now, sometimes things that I worked through, I get like obscenely passionate about, and I ask myself, Jesse, why does it like anger you so much when other people struggle with this, or why are you like so flamboyantly passionate about this? Because I worked through it and I know it's work throughable. And the reason that it took me a while to work through it is because I was saying baloney. I was lying to myself, being disingenuous with my true reasons why I wasn't growing my business. And that's why. So I'm actually upset about a former version of myself when I get angry at this. So if some of that comes out, and maybe it's going to come out a little bit with sarcasm, just remember, I love you and I want you to get past this like I've gotten past it. Okay. And I'm still getting past it. It's tough. But what we're talking about today is two pieces of nonsense that people say to not do outreach in their business. So outreach could be a cold call. It could be knocking on a door. Typically today, it's a message, okay? And here is what the top two reasons people say that they don't wanna do this, okay? And I said these things. See, it's already coming out. The sarcasm's already coming out. But I said these things. I'm talking to myself here. So if you've said these things, it's baloney. I'm explaining to you why it's baloney, but I've said these things too. Number one, it's disingenuous. It's disingenuous for me to send that to 50 people. I see. So you're sending a message out that says you're super excited about your business. You're not sure if it's for them or not because you don't know them. Maybe it is. Maybe it's not. Would they like to learn more? So exactly what part of that statement is fake? Are you not excited about your business? Well, then don't say that. If that's a lie, and I would say you're in the wrong business. Okay, so if that feels disingenuous, then you're in the wrong business if you're not excited about it. Okay, do you know if it's for them or not? No, you have no idea. It's a cold message. You have no idea if it's for them or not. So is that fake? Do you think it is? Or are you like projecting? Like, I don't think it is, but you have no idea. It's a cold message. You have no idea. So what's fake about that statement? Would you like to learn more? Well, are you a giver? Are you an educator? If they're like, oh my gosh, thank you so much for messaging me. Wow, this is crazy. I've been praying about this. Wow, this is crazy. Yes, I would like to learn more. Well, would you like to share more? So what exactly about that is disingenuous? Okay. What the real thing is it's a selfish thing. We don't want to be rejected. We don't want someone to send back what we think they might send back. Guys, I've been doing cold messaging for years, and I think I've gotten literally in years, two negative responses where one was negated because when I kind of just said these things to her, she was like, that is so tacky that you're like totally like copy and pasting that. And I just told her, I go, hey, I'm trying to affect mass amounts of people. This is the quickest way possible. There was nothing disingenuous here. I was honest. And she was like, well, yeah, you're right. Okay, thank you. All right. The other person was just a vile human being. All right. The second thing that I used to say that other people say, when I hear it, I just can't stand it because it's so blatantly wrong. It's just a mindset. You got to read the book, Rejection Proof. Please read that book. All right. It feels salesy. So many people are living in scarcity because they don't want to feel salesy. Well, there's already about that statement that's a selfish statement. Tell me how you feel. Is it about you or is it about helping human beings? Okay. Because you're saying, I feel salesy. Okay. What about helping other human beings? So number one, sales is just a transfer of energy and enthusiasm you have about your product or service to another human being. Some people are going to be excited about it. Some people aren't. If that's sales to you, and here's the thing. I found that the people that don't want to feel salesy are really, really good at explaining why they don't want to feel salesy. In other words, they're really good salespeople when it comes to staying right where they're at in scarcity instead of abundance by explaining why they're not good at sales or why they don't want to do sales. So they're really good at selling you on that fact. They just don't want to sell their product or service that they say helps other human beings. And then they say, I know, I'm getting charged. They say, oh, I just want to help people. You just want to help people, but you don't want to do sales. That makes no sense, okay? If you have a product or service, you're in sales. If you wanna help people, you're in sales, period. Or another thing that they might say, this is what I've heard too with the non-sales thing, is they'll say, hey, people will come to me if they want my product or service. Okay, I don't need to go and spam them and blow them up and, you know, plaster it on Facebook. They'll come to me if they really, wow, you're that popular. That's insane. So basically you're saying if you had the cure to cancer, man, they'll just come to you. The cancer patients in across the world would miraculously know that you have the cure. Find a plane ride to your home, show up and be like, hey, you got that cure? Come on, let's dissect that statement. Do you really think the mass amount of people know you exist, know that your product or service really exists? Of course not. We have to get out of our comfort zone. We have to let them know it exists and see if it's something that can benefit and enrich their life. Okay, I hate to say this, but if you're watching this video, you're just not that popular where everyone knows you exist and everyone knows what you do and everyone's just gonna throw their credit card at you because they're so envious in what you do. That's the first part of coaching, is we have to inspire people to make change. Hey, I'd love to hear your thoughts on this. Thanks for tuning in. Let me know in the comments. Hopefully this has helped you, because I feel once you get past these points with your outreach, your business is going to go to the next level. Thanks for tuning in.